Hey everyone, it's Andy, and today I'm going to show you how to create a project. ArcGIS Pro helps you organize and manage resources related to your work by using a project file. In this tutorial, we're going to create a project using our map template. Since our project is going to focus on endangered species, we'll give the project a name and it will open with a map view. The project will use Esri's Living Atlas to identify critical habitat areas for endangered species within California's San Bernardino National Forest. To focus on our area of interest, we'll use the locate pane and search for the San Gorgonio Mountain that's in the middle of the National Forest. Since we'll be frequently returning to this location, we'll create a bookmark for it. Now let's change the name of the map to something more appropriate by opening the map properties. There, that's better. Now to get a view of the area that displays the ground cover, we'll change our base map to imagery. Next, we're going to add data from Living Atlas. These layers will help us investigate which endangered species have critical habitat within the forest. The layer we've added contains quite a few parks. Since we're only interested in San Bernardino National Forest, we're going to create a new layer from the USA Parks layer we just added. We'll select the forest on the map, and then on the Data tab, choose Layer from Selection. Now that we have the selection layer, the original layer can be removed. The name of our new layer could be more descriptive, so let's rename it. The primary purpose of this layer is to serve as a boundary. We'll change the symbology to a bright yellow to make it stand out against the ground cover. Now let's add the critical habitats. Living Atlas is grouped categorically. Since we're looking for habitats, we can filter the search for datasets focused on species. Now let's add this USA Critical Habitat feature layer to the map. This layer contains polygons that cover the entire country, but since we're only interested in the San Bernardino National Forest, we use the geoprocessing tool CLIP to remove the polygons that are not within the forest boundary. We use the polygons for input features that we want to clip, the San Bernardino National Forest as the clip features, and provide a name for the output feature class that will be created as a result. After running the tool, we can see that all the features that were outside the forest boundary have been removed. Each of the polygons within the boundary represent different endangered species. In order to communicate that visually, we'll symbolize the layer by unique values. In the Field 1 drop-down list, we can select species type, and the symbology automatically assigns a unique color to amphibians, birds, fish, flowering plants, insects, and mammals. This data can also be viewed as a table. Here we can further explore the attributes to learn more about the types of endangered species living in the forest. To give this tutorial a try, head over to the ArcGIS Pro help.